In one of Paul Claudel's short plays, a blind girl asks a haunting question. You people who can see, what do you do with the light? That haunting question can likewise be asked of us who are the disciples of Christ. What do we do with the light? Each one of us, in our specific vocations, and those among us whose responsibility it is to administer justice. What is the light to which I refer? The light of faith. Yes, faith is often spoken of as a light in the Church's tradition. Pope Francis clearly stated this in the opening sentence of his first encyclical. I quote, "The light of faith. This is how the Church's tradition speaks of the great gift brought by Jesus. Those who believe see. They see with a light that illumines their entire journey, for it comes from the risen Christ, the morning star that never sets." Pope Francis then reminds us of the urgency for this light in our contemporary culture and society. "There is," he said, "an urgent need then to see once again that faith is a light. For once the light of faith dies out, all other lights begin to dim. The light of faith is unique, since it is capable of illuminating every aspect of human existence." Moreover, we Catholics are observing the Year of Faith, which will conclude on November 24th, the Solemnity of Christ the King. Since October 11th of the year 2012, our focus has been on faith in its many aspects and implications. It seems to be appropriate and timely to reflect on the administration of justice through the lens of the light of faith. Let me be clear. As I refer to the light of faith in speaking to those among us who administer justice, I am not implying that you should administer justice as professors of theology or catechists, or that you bring the doctrines of the Church into your legal briefs and judicial decisions. You administer justice using the rule of law, the principles of jurisprudence, and the entire corpus of legal decisions and studies. However, in your chosen profession of administrating justice, you are men and women who believe in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are in your very being disciples of the Lord Jesus and members of his church. The light of faith enables you to discharge your weighty responsibilities in the administration of justice for the common good with a different attitude and different energy. An attitude and an energy whose source is the Lord God, creator of the universe and redeemer of all peoples. By the light of faith, you understand why there is in our tradition the celebration of the Red Mass, and also why you have freely chosen to take part. Why is this Mass called the Red Mass? And what are its origins? Its origins lie in the basic conviction that the guidance of the Holy Spirit is indispensable in conducting human affairs, and therefore essential in conducting judicial and legal business, at least for those judges and lawyers who recognize and admit their radical dependence upon God and their genuine need for wisdom and insight, courage and strength, gifts which only God can give through the Holy Spirit. This is why we often pray in that very favorite prayers of ours to the Holy Spirit, give us right judgment and the joy of his counsel and guidance. During this Red Mass, so named because of the red vestments in honor of the Holy Spirit worn by the priests, together we seek from the Holy Spirit a greater outpouring of his sevenfold gift. In a particular way, we ask the Holy Spirit to inspire and strengthen all of you in the legal profession, especially judges and lawyers, that your participation in our legal system will contribute toward preserving moral values and providing justice for all people. After all, the practice of law is more than a job, more than a craft, more even than a profession. It is a participation in a system of justice, which by its very nature has profound moral implications. I turn to the words of one of your colleagues. Those who enter the law with the intent to bring justice to a broken world, to vindicate the rights of the weak and vulnerable, to heal broken relationships, to ensure equality to all persons, these persons have responded to a true calling. Law for them is a vehicle of service to God and to neighbor, not simply a gateway to financial and social success. By the light of faith, you perceive how the gifts of the Holy Spirit provide invaluable guidance as you exercise the administration of justice. Our first reading from the prophet Isaiah refers to these gifts of the Holy Spirit. At confirmation, these gifts were given to you, to us, for a lifetime of journeying in faith. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, Spirit of wisdom and understanding, a spirit of counsel and strength, a spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord. How do these gifts assist you and your responsibilities in administrating justice? Another colleague of yours related each of these seven gifts to your work, and I quote him. Wisdom enables us to judge as God would judge, or Christ. Quid nunc Christus is the Latin. What would Christ do if he were in my shoes now? Understanding. Here the Holy Spirit helps us with the tough ones, the hard cases that without his help make bad law. Counsel. It helps us to find the right word, the right bit of advice that inspires trust and confidence in our clients. It's what they really come to us to find. Fortitude. The other quality our clients look for. When we know our client is right, when we know which way a decision should go, we don't back down, not in the face of political pressure, nor in the fear of the media, and not for the fear of spending more time than our fee will cover. Knowledge. Some would call it street smarts, but when it comes to the spirit comforter, we needn't fear that it will be contaminated by pettiness or cynicism. Piety, which could also be called faithfulness, dependability, or loyalty. What can be said? What higher honor for a lawyer than to be known as a person whose word is his bond and who can be counted on in good times and bad, especially in a partnership? And finally, fear of the Lord. What a valuable gift is fear of the Lord. The gift tells us lawyers that we are accountable for what we do and that to bear our burden of accountability on the last day, we must make ourselves accountable to someone now, to our spouse, our partners, to our priest. No, we didn't carry the load we do and stay honest without day-to-day accountability solidly rooted in fear of the Lord. Fear of the Lord makes us conscious of our own weakness, but trustful of God's mercy and hopeful of his provident goodness. End of quote. I urge you to ask God the Holy Spirit to assist you by the outpouring of his seven gifts in your daily endeavors. And finally, by the light of faith, you grasp more readily and more deeply that this light is of service to you in the administration of justice. Pope Francis spent considerable time on this specific issue in his encyclical. I quote just a part of it. Precisely because it is linked to love, the light of faith is concretely placed at the service of justice, law, and peace. The light of faith is capable of enhancing the richness of human relations, their ability to endure, to be trustworthy, to enrich our life together. Faith does not draw us away from the world or prove irrelevant to the common, to the concrete concerns of the men and women of our time. Faith makes us appreciate an architecture of human relationships because it grasps their ultimate foundation and definitive destiny in God. It is love, and thus sheds light on the art of building. As such, it becomes a service to the common good. Faith is truly a good for everyone. It is a common good. Its light does not simply brighten the interior of the church, nor does it serve solely to build an eternal city in the hereafter. It helps us to build our societies in such a way that they can journey toward a future of hope. And then the Pope observes much later on, how many benefits has the gaze of Christian faith brought to the city of men for their common good? Thanks to faith, we have come to understand the unique dignity of each person, something which is not clearly seen in antiquity. Faith, by revealing the love of the Creator, enables us to respect nature all the more and discern in it a grammar written by the hand of God and a dwelling place entrusted to our protection and care. Faith also helps us devise models of development which are based not simply on utility and profit, but consider creation as a gift for which we are all indebted. It teaches us to create just forms of government in the realization that authority comes from God and is meant for the service of the common good. End of quote. Yes, the light of faith enables you to administer justice from the Creator's intent and will that every human being is made in God's image and likeness and possesses an inestimable dignity and worth, coupled with basic rights, which no one, no law, and no government can deny or remove. A new judicial year has dawned. How in need each of us is, and especially you, who are daily and deeply involved in the administration of justice, of the Holy Spirit's assistance and guidance. We, however, are not disappointed or fearful. God's word in today's second reading makes us a promise on which we can lean and trust. The Spirit comes to our weakness. If we do not know how to pray as we ought, the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. I encourage you, even more, I urge you, daily to turn to God the Holy Spirit. Today's account, the Lord Jesus confirms that he sends the Advocate to us. When he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. In your weighty duties as judges and lawyers and paralegal professionals, turn often, yes, daily, to God the Holy Spirit. Prior to research, to legal briefs, to judicial hearings, and to trials, seek the Lord's light and guidance. After all, He is our advocate and stays always by our side. Dear friends all, I end as I began. The Red Mass is so named because the color of the vestments is red, honoring the Holy Spirit, whose guidance and assistance we are seeking. Red is also the sign of blood. This Red Mass reminds all those committed to the practice of law and all those committed to the moral law, the truth, justice, and the defense of each person's life and dignity are required of us. In the witness of daily life, yes, in the exercise of our vocations and professions, yes, even to the shedding of blood. Be not afraid. The Holy Spirit is with us, indeed within us. And so we pray. Come, Holy Spirit, make us wise, make us strong, make us authentic, make us true disciples of Jesus Christ, for the common good of people, for the life of the world. Yes, the blind girl's haunting question keeps echoing in our ears and hearts. What do you do with the light? Acknowledging our radical dependence on God, we respond. By the light of faith, we discern what is good and right and just. By the light of faith, we truly